This mission with the peace of the Lord. My brothers, at this time we are here to transmit the Sunday school of the church Maranatha that we do to all the churches every Sunday around this time through our center of communications, our central communications, and the state of Villa Velha Espírito Santo. And before starting the service and our study, we want to share with the brothers the presence, the brothers from Ipatinga, from the state of Minas Gerais. The brothers are here, they're participating with us, elaborating the Sunday school. We have here the brothers, the pastors from that region of Ipatinga, participating with us this morning. Also, we want to tell the brothers that it was done last weekend, a seminar in the Maninha of Belo Horizonte, and it was around 1,200 brothers in that seminar of Belo Horizonte. And we are really happy with the brothers from the port of Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais. And also there was a service, a special service that was done in a rural, rural part. It was Pompano da Serra in the state of Minas Gerais too. And the service was done in a farm where there was 32 visitors and the brothers. And a family, one was watching the service, that family defined themselves to Jesus. And now they're watching live the Sunday school. And we plead these brothers with the peace of the Lord. We also want to give a salutation to the brothers of Itaperuna in the state of Rio de Janeiro, where there's a seminar happening in Itaperuna. And the brothers at this moment, they're participating of the Sunday school. There's Pastor Joel, Pastor Everaldo, and also we plead those with the peace of the Lord. It was also done a seminar with the families and the money of Umberlândia, the state of Minas Gerais. And now the brothers are there and they're watching the Sunday school. And we also plead and we give all our salvation and the peace of the Lord. Another information that makes us happy is that it's been happening this weekend, some evangelizations in Rio de Janeiro, in the Church of Gavia, Rio de Janeiro. And this evangelization is happening also in the spirit, in the state of Espírito Santo, Parnaíba, Minas Gerais, and also brothers from Aracaju, and they're also participating. And now they are in the park, in the city, in the community, called Community of Rocinha, where it's happening the first Sunday school. And now they're watching live through satellite, and we thank all them. And we also want to thank all the brothers from the church, Cateto, Rio de Janeiro. They're always participating. The pastor, Paulo Teixeira, the deacon, Wonder, and the brothers are there, you know, participating with us. We plead with the peace of the Lord. My brothers, we're going to start at this moment the study of this morning. This study is going to tell us a teach. It's special. And this teach is based on the experience of the Old Testament and Nehemiah. In the book of Nehemiah, Pastor Jadoti, he's going to give an introduction about the subject, and the questions are going to be towards the verse 17 through 22. My brothers, peace of the Lord. First of all, we want to tell the brothers that we also had a video conference with them brothers and pastors in Israel. Brothers and pastors from Israel. We saw in the beginning that just a few understand, just a few didn't reach. It is because the work of the Holy Spirit is not a denomination, religious. We don't need to follow denomination. It's not what the pastor decides to preach and says that's a contest. No. The work of the Holy Spirit is the Spirit. It doesn't matter if that person, it is not another denomination. What matters, it is, if it is his obeying, if he's obeying the same Spirit, the same call, the same project, if everything, it is disposable to the Christian at this time. The work of the Spirit, it doesn't measure the number of people or organizations, not even foundations, theological foundations, structures. The work, it's not a religion that is locked in a past that doesn't work anymore, that doesn't walk, that needs new things every day to attract you. And the worst part is that those things that are new, they're bringing. It is that the leader that is ready to obey is ready. No, it depends. So flash, it is everywhere. So you can see flash in the supermarket, you can see in the beach, you know. You can always see, you know, in the places that people dress up just to look good. Just like, you know, you get a haircut, you do the eyebrows. Just want people taking care of the other person. But there's no problem. I don't see anything bad, you know. Man. Alright, there's man that does eyebrows. But okay, it's kind of... in the work, in church, that doesn't work, you know. We need to define our position. It's not against anyone. It's not against preferences. But the word, the man at this work, it needs to be men and women. They have a, they have to follow a rule, because if they fall, if they dress like this, if they dress like that, they need to follow, just like what the Spirit is saying. So your position, it is, give testimony. All right, so let's go. So today, we came here. And we had a meeting to start coffee, you know, we were talking. And I came back, Pastor Gilson. What is the message that we would be preaching today? Let's talk right here. Alright, so we were drinking a coffee. And we were talking, we were chatting. And then there was a subject of what we are here the first time bringing it. That is a place for service in the community of Rocinha. And later on, Pastor Joseph was like, oh, you remember, you know, what was done with the group, you know, and they used that until today. So that could be, you know, justify. So we always have this group from Ipatinga. They're always passing by. And we actually consult the Lord, and the Lord showed that the subject should be directed to this group of brothers that are here in the community of Rocinha. I want to say with grace, I'm really satisfied to say that this point, this place that could stay or not, and this place, it won't ever close. It won't ever taken away. If there is a place there, the church will keep a group doing evangelizing. And the people of level, social level, based, you know, when everyone qualifies, that is not the best one. It doesn't have a greater power. They have to stay in those kind of places. We don't think, we think that we could change today. Those who are in the community of Rocinha, they could be down there. You know, they could be all the way down there talking about Jesus, because many of those who are down there, they're testifying for the flesh. Human doesn't want to know about work. Not even that the Jesus is soon to come. What they want to live their life. And not only the ones that are like on the beach, you know. It could be also the ones in Ipatinga, the ones that think that the beach is far. And the beach is way closer than they think. You know, LeBron, Copacabana. We have to remember that what we have to do is not, it is, it's not, it is the shore of the beach. On the 31st is not to walk and see what the world have to offer. That's the great problem. And the pastor wants to have to see that. And we are fighting for that. We see you clear, but people don't like the truth. Know the truth, and the truth will... what's that? Condemn. So, when they're talking, people, when they talk about Bible, they know that they know everything. They know about Revelation and everything. But they don't have a compromise with the church. And at this moment here, it's a moment of clear, that we need to be really clear. There's nothing to hide, because those who knows everything, they don't need to be hearing what they are hearing right now. Alright, let's go for a text. Let's go for a verse right here. The time it is to reconstruct. The time it is of reconstruct. Oh, you forgot right there. Let's go to read the verse with me. And then I said, it was Nehemiah 4:19. I'm sorry. So the side says 4:19. Let's read with me, everyone. All right. Then I said to the nobles, the rulers, and the rest of the people, the work is great and extensive, and we are separated far from one another on the wall. My brothers, who don't understand the extension of this word, a work that is in this the whole world? The brother asked, I'm gonna put here. Oh, how many? So let's put something that makes the brothers wake up. So we had a supper that was almost worldwide that no one else ever had. We have brothers, and we have 9 pastors in Israel. They're really interested. And one of the concerns of the brothers in Israel, it was one of the subject. It was fellowship, to show what is fellowship. Fellowship is not to group some people, make a little group and talk something that is not related to Jesus. Fellowship, it is when you feel the Holy Spirit. When you feel the Holy Spirit, it is when you have fellowship. So after the resurrection, it was the glory of the Lord. The glory of the Lord manifested and the fellowship. So today we're going to see clearly and show those brothers that are in the community of Rocinha the fellowship. So they're gonna be like, oh, alright, so this is it. So there was a power, a greater power towards the focus of the Church of Hosea. There's a weird group, you know, they're visiting, but the light, it's on right there, and the light will not turn off. We don't need money. You brothers are there in this community. You even have, if you have condition, you can contribute, but don't do that. You know, you don't need to go out and find money to bring to the inside of the church. Your money is to, like, take care of your life. And we do whatever the Holy Spirit determines. We don't need resources, because the work, it is from the Holy Spirit. We're not asking from anyone. So just come for your community right now. And now that you're right there listening to us, and Hosea in the whole world, and the whole world, into this Hosea that is the whole world. We are talking to the every Hosea in the whole world. To the colonels, lawyers, judges, to everyone. We are talking to these people. That the time, it is, what time? It is a time of reconstruction. What is the situation that lived Israel on that time? First, Jerusalem, it was left. The walls were set on fire. The people that stayed, they became poor because there was no production, and they didn't know how they would leave right there. So they were trying to do everything they could. And it came from the part of the Lord in order to reconstruct Jerusalem. My brothers, look at this. Look right there, the city of the Lord. It was the city of the Lord. So the Lord had been given a city in our disposal. He gave us all the benefits, just like he did to Israel. But now, the city was empty, you know, without kids, you know, animals. Was left there. It was abandoned. But Jerusalem was the city of the Lord. Yeah. Yeah, Jerusalem. So Jesus gave Jerusalem so people could adore the Lord in Jerusalem. But if the people didn't adore the Lord until now, the Messiah will sit in the throne right there in Jerusalem. The objective is done. The man, he makes part of this project or not? What happened to Israel? It lost the city. Why did it lost the city? Oh, if Jerusalem, it is to adore the Lord and not talk about other subjects. So they'll talk about Jerusalem. So let's go to the walls, cries. Let's go to the rivers and cry because of Jerusalem. If it is not to serve the Lord, to glorify the Lord, why Jerusalem? If the work is not from the Spirit, why are you there? You are there. It is for the Spirit. If it's not from the Spirit, why would you stay there? Don't lose your time. Don't waste your time to do what everyone's doing. But it's obvious. Oh, you're telling people to leave the place? No. Whoever don't want, and those who are prejudicating the people that come the last day of the year. Oh, they're gonna talk about Christmas or whatever. No. Yeah, they would even turn off the satellite because, you know, they have to travel. They have to see people, and they would think they know. And stopping what the Holy Spirit has for us, you stop. No, that's not gonna happen. So we baptized the other day 36 people. 18 of them, they accepted the Lord through the satellite. Every day we're getting lessons. Oh, you wanna invite people for the service tonight? Why, to convert them? If you don't wanna follow the lead, I'm already converted, you know, I'm from the work. I work without compromise. When you work that talks bad things about the other people, when you have disrespect from one spirit, so you don't know how to discern the left and the right hand. But it's right here. The text that we read, it is out of order right here. So look right here. And said to the nobles, this work, it is for the nobles. It is for those who take care of the things of the Lord. Seriously. The rest of the people. This work is not for pastor that wants a title and doesn't want a mystery. Title anyone could have. But if you want to, you can always go and buy a title of pastor. But a mystery, it is when the work of the Lord, it is done. It is actually put in work. If I left that work, it is because I went to one that Jesus actually called me. So I have to do whatever the Holy Spirit tells me to do. So first day of the year. So let's say we're talking about the first Sunday school of the year. We're talking about those brothers in the community of Hacinha. My brothers, you there up there, and this hardest part, you have to go up. You're gonna have to go through hard places. And we're not because we're talking about community of Hacinha. Oh, that place is not good, you know. The community of Hacinha, it has the same number, it has the same value of the souls that are down there. The beach, that are spending whatever they have. But look, it's not the social condition that we care. We don't care how much you have. You could come from whatever to the house of the Lord. But the only thing is that you need to understand that you were in the world, that the walls were set on fire, that the city, the adoration, was left alone, where you're gonna find all the struggles. And I want to tell your brothers that in the Hacinha and worldwide, and I want to say that Sabla and Tobias, they're here. They don't want this work, but you're gonna have to fight for it. This space is yours. This work is yours. It's from the Holy Spirit. And it was given to the glory and honor to the Lord. So this beginning right now, it is for you to answer some aspects. Oh, we could and ended up just talking about this. But we are focusing, you know. So we left to the side a little of about Revelation. That many light, you know. Oh, and another, they were like, oh, we're still reading Revelations. Oh, so you know everything, huh? So this is not how it works. It's interesting, because all those who tells me they knows everything, when I ask one question, they don't know how to answer. They can't answer one question, one of the simplest questions. You say that you know everything, but you know nothing. What is missing is for you to be humble. You have to look and seek the Lord for understanding and understand that this moment, this prophetic moment, it is a work that the Holy Spirit is doing it for us. It's putting in work. Oh, you can say, oh, Hacinha is dangerous. No, dangerous, it's everywhere. You know, it's more dangerous to be in the beach singing, you know. So, the sin is not on the beach or in a place. No, the sins are in the people. So it's not a subject for us, but we wanted to tell all the community of Hosnia they could come down and, you know, enjoy the work. This ocean that is drowning all the adolescents, youths, families that are being buried on the mud of sins. I'm gonna ask a question right now. Read. I'm gonna give you 3 minutes for your brothers to read. And Nehemiah 4. 4 what? 17 to 22. Right? I'm not gonna turn it off. Nehemiah 4:17 through 22. Now the question is with me. It's not with Gilson. Gilson is too kind. Alright? And I'm gonna be the one asking the questions. And there was a question that we couldn't give last time, but I'm gonna give it this time. Alright? So, read the verse, Nehemiah 17 to 22. I didn't ask you to put this in here. I told them to read. Primeiro they're gonna read. And this question you can leave it. No. Wait up. I want you to put the text. Nehemiah 4:17 through 22. Alright? Could that work? Alright, let's go. Not because your brothers didn't have time to read, I'm gonna read with you. Alright, my brother, read with the brothers. 17 through 22. Those who built on the wall and those who carry burdens loaded themselves so that with one hand they worked at the construction, with the other they held a weapon. Verse 18. Every one of the builders had his sword gritted at his side as he built, and the one who sounded the trumpet was beside me. Verse 19. Then I said to the nobles, the rulers, and the rest of the people, the work is great and extensive, and we are separated far from one another on the wall. Verse 20. Whenever you hear the sound of the trumpet, rally to us there. Our God will fight for us. 21. So we labored in the work, and half of the men held the spears from daybreak until their stars appeared. 22. At the same time, I also said to the people, let each man and his servants stay a night in Jerusalem, that they might be our guard by night and working part by day. Amen. Alright, let's go to the first questions. So let's go to the questions now. Let's go to the first question. So let's go, we already finished reading. So the question is, reading the text on Nehemiah 4:19, what does it mean, the expression, we are separated far from one another? Use 2 words to define prophetic. To define the text. So let's find 2 words that could define prophetically the text. All right. Alright, let's go. Did anyone find her? Alright, my brothers, we can see the answer right now, and the word, and we say fellowship. When there is no fellowship, there is nobody. And there you go, two words that defines prophetically the expression, we are separated far from one to another. The same thing, I was missing body, and I was missing fellowship. If there's nobody, there's no fellowship. We're missing the project of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. The Old Testament doesn't need that. It was rituals. The obedience of the law, not here. The union, it is to obey the law, not here. We, it is the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Whoever determines our relationship is God. And our relationship to the brother. There's only body. The word body, prophetically, exists as church. In the mystery of the church, he was the body. In the mystery of the church, whoever recognizes that, it is our Christ Jesus and the Holy Spirit operating in this body. The life of Jesus that was in the body of Jesus started to become part of the with Jesus. Let's go to our second question. And our second question says, what is the prophetically meaning of the expression sound of the trumpet of verse 20? And what is the person of the Trinity that this text is referring to? So let's go, let's find verse 20. What is the prophetically meaning of the expression, whenever you hear the sound of the trumpet? If you know, you can answer. The brothers that are here too, you can answer. If you know, God, you can stand up, you know, and just give the answer. Not the pastor. The brother that are sure. So we are here just to help, you know. Amen. Done. Alright, so here nobody knows. So if nobody knows, we're gonna give the answer already. So it's right here. The sound of the trumpet, it is related to actually. So the meaning of the sound of the trumpet, it is related to the moment that we are living. That is the sound of the trumpet of the last time. So it says, what else? Everything is right, you know. You can live here. Is there anything else to say? The sound of the trumpet is what? It is the voice of the Holy Spirit. It is prophetic. Alright. In the prophetic moment. Pastor Justin left to the pastor who knows, pastor of the church, the sound of the trumpet, it is the voice of the Holy Spirit. It's not what we're waiting, it's not just that, but it's related through a gathering. We're talking about a time of reconstruction. To reconstruct, whoever is not listening to the sound of the trumpet, if you can hear what the Holy Spirit is determining, if you can hear that, there is no reunion, there is no gathering, there is no pleading. The brothers in Pachinga, they're going to take this message, and each one of them are going to preach in their churches. Yeah, you like Twitter sometime, huh? Alright, let's go to the third question for today. So, continue. Comparing the text of Nehemiah 4, 17-22. Show a participation of Christianity in our days. What is the participation of Christianity in our days in the context of this passage, Nehemiah 17-22? So the brothers, now they're going to give the answer. Comparing the text, Nehemiah 4:17-22. So how is the Christianity of our days in the context of this passage, in this text? Helping in the answer. We're living the world, we're living a Christianity that which the walls disappeared. There is no walls. We could say that they put fire on the walls and they opened Jerusalem to bring sins inside of Jerusalem to the church. That's the situation. There's a Christianity that opened up the walls, that put fire, it was abandoned, and there was a world that came inside. What was the world? It was the sadness, it was the abandoned. What was the missing of the food, dryness, and the vision that you have, it is of a sick land that was fire there, then there is no way that you can fix it. Elijah, he couldn't do anything. So there is only one situation. Either we will understand that we have a responsibility, not as Church Maranatha, but as the work to reconstruct the wall, and we're gonna probably talk about this in the next Sunday school, how we're gonna rebuild the walls. So write it down, you know. So let's finish it up. So those who like to read the Bible, let's see how we can rebuild the walls. So nobody's gonna bring soldiers here that they're not gonna put in practice. We actually want people. We are gonna rebuild the walls. You say, I will rebuild the wall. Can we continue? Oh yeah, the doors. Oh, we're gonna go through the doors. The doors of the dragons, you know. 3 days traveling. Why? Because door is holy. So the man only discovers if he walks through the door. So he cannot step it wrong. So he needs to let the Holy Spirit guide him. So the thorns, the sickness, the enemies, they need to be really well prepared to go through these situations. So you say, oh, the problem is at your house. Oh, that person, you know, he's prepared, he's smart. First place, the pastor doesn't obey. Oh, there you go, he went to the world. You know, he had classes to give and the son didn't accept. So he didn't watch what he was supposed to. That is the moment that we're living. The pastor says something that he wasn't supposed to. Why? Because when people are saying that, some people are saying this. What kind of church is that? And what kind of church is that the person can go and talk about things that doesn't even make sense? For what? And the church was empty. That's a problem. There it is. And then you can say, oh, pastor, oh, do you know about this? Do you know about this? Oh, so. And you know, we can't be right here, you know, without a breath. We have to say whatever it needs to be said in the church. You can't say, oh, everyone's saved, you know, just because you timed. Oh, you can be whoever you want. Your value, it isn't to obey the things of the Lord. Just like your brothers. I want to ask a favor. You take care of your life. And our concern, we're not talking about this to offend anyone. Our concern is not this. What if I'm talking so much that I'm not even going to heaven? If you're not satisfied with me, you're the one that goes. I'll say, tell them the truth. And you that doesn't want the truth, you can go to heaven. So look here. So let's give the answer. So what is in the concept of Christianity that we're living through in this text? It is right here in verse 19. It is to understand that the work, it is dense, it's big. It is, the work is great and it's extensive. And we are separated far from one to another on the wall. So the text said, and then it said to nobles, the rulers, and the rest of the people, the work is great and extensive. And we are separated far from one to another on the wall. So they say, oh, pastor, you have to go to that church. You have to go to do. No, that doesn't exist. You have to change. He got old there. If he's destroying the church, he needs to leave. We know pastors here that they can say, oh, one of the biggest church, he had to leave. Do you know where he went? He went to Mabrik. He went to a smaller church. What happened? Oh, the Lord just revealed that he had to leave, you know? That happens. So, people that think that if they take them away from one church, they'll die spiritually, they need to do something about it, you know? That can happen. So, that was a question that nobody was asking for. And we came here, you know? I'm sorry for the brothers that were with us. Oh, we still have 5 minutes. Oh, we can ask. Alright, so go. Question. Identify in the text of Nehemiah 4:18. I identify the Trinity. Identify the Trinity in Nehemiah 4:18. So let's go with me. Let's read. Every one of the builders had his sword. The sword talks about what? The sword talks about the sword girded. A sword girded talks about what? The Father. Girded at his side. His side talks about what? Body. As he built. And the trumpet talks about what? The Holy Spirit. And the one who sounded the trumpet. And first talks about the Father. That is the trumpet. And Jesus is where? Was beside me. It was with me, it was with them, the spirit. It was with me, the figure of Nehemiah. It was the one that was identifying as Jesus. So my brothers, once again, our happiness to breed the brothers who are in the Hacienda, the community of Hacienda in Rio de Janeiro. Hacienda Salam. We don't have cathedrals, temples, the same way. Because our temple, it is based on the construction of greatness, rich, but of gold. The gold is the word of the Lord. The pulpit here, it is made of gold. The word, it is. And you can only see the gold if you understand the word. And we ask the brothers to keep praying for us, you know, on WhatsApp, you know. Yeah, right there. Oh, people say it doesn't that. No, pray more. That's what I'm asking. Pray more. So, my brothers, everyone, a peace of the Lord. Let's sing a song. Amen. My brothers, stand up at this time. The kids are singing a song. Amen. The kids, adolescents, can kneel down at this time. Amen. Pastor Sabato, if you could pray. My father, we also prayed again for the misery We want to present an altar, our kids, intermediaries, adolescents of your house. And we want to ask you, Lord, that your day, that your Holy Spirit every day could guide them in a way that they could be prepared, that they could be prepared every day. Preserve their life, their health, give them salvation, fellowship with the love that you, that they could love their, that every day that your name could be glorified. We take the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Lord, take our service in a way of gratitude for the that your word could stay in our hearts. It could generate life, grace, transformation, compensation, that we could better serve you. Take us in peace. This is the prayer we do in the name of Jesus. And in your name we say that the grace, the holy grace of our God, Savior Jesus Christ, the love of our eternal Father, the sweets, consolations, and the gifts of the Holy Spirit could be upon us now and forever. Amen. The brothers may be seated. At night, 6:15, youth's meeting. Service at 7:30. So let's be praying for the two events that we're going to have so we could have a blessing. This week, we're going to do, we're actually going to buy the church. So on the 15th or 16th of this week. So we ask the brothers to be praying, you know, so we could have no problems. Everything shows in the case that we're not going to have any problem, you know, with the place. So we ask the brothers to be praying for that. And we're going to sooner be looking for the, you know, restoration so we could have service in there. Praise the Lord to everyone.